Mike Allen. Welcome to the 50 Politicos to Watch Party. We're at Barcode, 17th and L. It's a little hip for me. They did find some white wine for me, which I appreciated. But 50 Politicos to Watch is our way to look ahead to this exciting political season that's coming. So we try and win the morning. This time we're going to win the cycle. So we're looking ahead to the people who are going to be making news in South Carolina, New Hampshire, Iowa. Looking ahead to the people who are going to be running the conventions. Republicans down in Tampa, Democrats in Charlotte. We've got some tweeters. We've got some bloggers. And so the idea is to mix up the people that are on your radar screen. Now, somebody just asked me, I don't know very many of those people. That's the idea, is to get to know them. So these are the faces that are going to be making the news in the year ahead, and we're excited to salute them here in the 50 Politicos to Watch. I'm going to head inside. Janet, what can I order that would make me seem a little hipper than a white wine?
A mojito.
Okay, mojito. Here I come.
I mean, I'm serious. I'm standing here with goosebumps. On the cover, caricature, and then in the middle. Smack dab in the middle. Woo! Thank you, Politico. Thank you. I don't know what I did to deserve this honor. Thank you so much. I'm not even looking at the career. It's just, I mean, just to be recognized for what you do. I've been here for 14 years, and it's just amazing. I still don't believe it. Forgive my throat. I have allergies, but, this is amazing. It is amazing. It is amazing. It's amazing. It's amazing. And I'm very thankful. What does it do for my career? I don't know. Let's wait and see. Next 2 months, 3 years, I don't know. But I'm going to keep on doing them. Keep on holding people accountable. Holding their feet to the fire.
I'm Steve Clemens. I'm Washington Editor-at-Large of The Atlantic. I'm also a senior fellow at the New America Foundation. I think lists are great. They're fun. They get us all looking to see. I don't think I'm on the list because someone would have called to say, Steve, you know, you're one of the it people in the 50 Politicos to Watch. In fact, I can't believe I'm not on the list because a lot of people, you know, are watching. But anyway, I do enjoy it. I like seeing from a virtual way. Is that working? Oh, you do. Okay, you're doing it. I like to see in a virtual way who's up and who's down. And maybe I'm sideways, but it's great. Look at this. This is great. These are all friends of ours. Anyway, congratulations to the 50 Politicos to Watch.
I'm Bill Platt of CBS News, and I was astonished to find myself on a list in Politico's 50 Politicos to Watch magazine. They came around and took a picture a couple of weeks ago, didn't really know what it was for. They said it was for Politico, okay. And then I discovered that along with Ann Compton, Mark Noller, my colleague, and April Ryan, I'm one of the deans, quote-unquote. That just means that I've been around for a long time. I think I made the list only because I survived.
Fred Thompson, and I'm here at the political party with my wife, Jennifer, and we're having a great time. And I've been asked why I'm on this political list, and I have no idea. But free food and drink, and it's a good enough reason for me.
I'm Mike Allen from Politico TV. We're here with Nora Donald, one of the 50 Politicos to Watch.
And
now the chief White House correspondent and Pam Stevens is going to join us. No, Pam, come join. Nora's now a chief correspondent, a chief White House correspondent for CBS News. I'm a front row for second week now.
That's right, my second week.
You picked your time with a lot going on.
It's been huge. It's been a lot of fun. CBS is fantastic, and covering the White House at this time has exceeded expectations, and an important story. And thank you for Politico for your nice recognition. I had no idea. Do you have something that you had?
You're always Politico to Watch. Now, Nora Donald also is an author, and is there more to come?
Baby Love, yes, is the original book. There might be a book in the future, but since I've been working, I have no idea what my kids are eating. So.
And what's life over there tonight?
Well, at this point, we're all on hold because we look like being here has a boat, so we'll see. I mean, I'm going back over there in a couple of hours.
And a quick fun fact about Nora. Nora, one of her first jobs in Washington was a roll call. So we're going to roll call in an incredible era when your colleagues included
Jim Vandehei, who happens to be the
executive editor
of Politico, big boss man. Ed Henry, who's now the chief White House correspondent for Fox.
Yes.
Jake Tapper, who's the chief White House correspondent or senior White House correspondent for ABC News.
Glasser.
Susan Glasser.
John Bresnahan.
John Bresnahan.
Yeah.
Mark Santoro, who's with the New York Times. I mean, there were a lot of stars, and I was just a newbie at that time, so I learned from all of them.
Well, Nora, congratulations.
I'm Ann Compton from ABC News, and having started at the White House at age 27, I never expected to walk in tonight and find out I'm finally an overnight sensation. I've actually made not only the cover, I'm totally surprised, I had no idea this was going to happen, not only the cover of a Politico magazine, but with so many cool people. You know, I look at the Politico staff now and I say, this is where journalism's heading. So I was just glad to be invited tonight, having no idea I was in a magazine.